Hello, my name is Japheth Omojuwa. I am a speaker, blogger, and writer. In many African societies, police are neither respected nor appreciated. Police are supposed to protect the people, but when corruption and abuse are rampant, they are feared and avoided. The question is, why does this happen? One reason is over-criminalization. In societies that lack rule of law, police are already empowered to discriminate against and terrorize citizens without accountability. But when legislators pass laws that turn everything into a crime, police abuses become inevitable. Each criminal law creates new opportunities for police officers to interact with citizens. In healthier societies, where the laws are limited to protecting the rights of everyone equally, the role of police is to help people when they've been hurt or wronged, and they only engage violently with criminals who are endangering other people's lives. Unfortunately, in much of Africa, laws are not restricted to protecting human rights. In South Africa, it's illegal to buy a television without a license. In Mozambique, you can't paint your own house without a permit. In Sudan, men and women aren't allowed to sit together without a chaperone. And as more aspects of the people's lives become criminalized, the role of the police changes. Instead of taking on the difficult work of stopping thieves and murderers, they seek out citizens who may not even know they've done anything against the law. When this happens, police power can quickly get out of control. In South Africa, which has one of the worst rankings for rule of law in the world, police brutality has tripled since the early 2000s. And in Nigeria, police routinely use torture to extract confessions from citizens. Across the continent, bribery and abuse are commonplace, and many police officers think they are above the law. People shouldn't be afraid of their police. They should look to them when they need help and safety. Ending over-criminalization means making sure that laws are just and fair. It means holding police accountable for their actions and removing legislators who empower corruption. It means having a society where citizens are in control of their police and not one where police abuse their citizens.